Yeah, I'm not going to go ahead with the introduction. Well, not today. I swear the pilots in this game is just fucking dumb. Freaking. You're right, I wasn't supposed to be over here. There was some shit I was gonna fuck up. What was it? Something I was supposed to mess up. Oh, I'm starting to love this one. Something's going on. Something's going on in my workplace. Andrew, are you okay?
You're dumb as shit.
Okay, I think apparently my little brother's having a mental breakdown. Up with him. Anyhow. Yeah. I completely forgot how the hell it is that I hit party before. Okay, let's do it. Alright, let's go. Oh. Wait. What the heck happened here? What the heck just happened here? I figured people would have cleaned that up by now. And somehow I kind of feel like I have to apologize for cutting the last episode short. Probably just not making it a two-parter. I feel like I'm hitting something. But still a mess. Of course. I'm not that. Okay, it's around here somewhere. Not resting my trusty tools to get it done. Okay. I gotta assess the situation. Let's see. Let's just assess the situation. Okay, we got a guy with a Bible. One shot out of do it. Ready to go? That didn't do him. Sure, that did. Wait, hang on. Hang on, I'm lost. Nope, y'all can't be 100% sure. Okay. Yeah, make sure no one's nearby. Okay. Fire it all. Well, sure, C4 can do that much damage, but when, but not a grenade launcher. That's just racist. Quite the region I was expecting. Name of the applicant, Thomas Salvage and Recovery. Silverlake, Montana. Screwed along with pilot Fred Tanner. Went down 8 March 2013. Recovered lockbox from a fuselage. Key to the lockbox. Find the key and open. Ah, damn, it's gonna suck. Oh! Shit. Oh wait, they weren't kidding. He was kidding when they said that they send the chopper team. Keep it that way. There it is. Ooh, I feel bad for the pilot. Luckily there's a boat. Bad for the guy that didn't get it in time.
We've lost some good men out there. Jacob will have to train up some more to take their place.
Nope. Looks a bit, Jacob sounds bad. Okay. Question is, where do I go next? Cheeseburger. Go get cheeseburger. Such a great scenery. What the? Oof. That's a word then.
What Jacob will do next. Fucker's crazy.
That ain't how I think. You and me both. Yeah, I probably should have regretted not taking the bow. Okay. Yeah, but the sounds of it, it looks like they most likely know on it. So, like I'm also the controls to this, I don't know where the hell I'm going. Half of the time, I don't even know what I'm doing. Thank you. I'm gonna see if I can get a shot at both of them. Okay, they know I'm here. One thing I don't. Oh, try to let him down. They just keep pushing. That didn't go quite as planned. They did not see me. What's up? Okay, so the alarm was back on this room. Maybe we'll have to do an alarm system.
Always thought Joseph had these assholes on a tight leash.
Do not feed animals. So bad could come of that. Other than that. Other than the mutilation of feeding. History of Cheeseburger the Bear. So that's why you call him Cheeseburger.
Nice one, Depp. Colt can't train those judges at the Fang Center anymore. Fowler Brothers is gonna be happy to get those grounds back. Might be worth asking around to see where that bear Cheeseburger ran off to. Heard he's out there tearing up Colt.
I'm just glad to see it out of the cult's hands, training those wolves to cause hell. And they've been shipping those crazy wolves all the way to the old lumber mill. Keep an eye on prisoners. Now, we had a bear here named Cheeseburger. Bit of a local celebrity, actually. Had a soft spot for Chad's barbecue. But he got the diabetes, so we put him on a liquid salmon diet. Anywho, cult tried to take him, so I set him free. Last I heard, he was causing all sorts of mayhem. Someone should go find him. Make sure he's all right. Grab some salmon from the pond ahead of time, though. Then feed Cheeseburger that salmon, and he'll be eating out of the palm of your hand.
What?
There's still good people up here, but
Wait a minute. Ah, damn it. I knew I shouldn't have sold that trough. Anyways. Sharky, let's go. Oh, shot doing over there. Yeah, I'll meet him over there. All right, Sharky, let's go.
We got some targets.
I'm looking for a little bit of fun. Hey, yeah.
Well, I'm just saying, I'm glad I carried that.
Let's go.
My clean, thank you very much. Talking to a gentleman.
Alright, where are the fishing spots? Right at the fishing spot, they say.
That might fuck up the undercarriage.
Not sure if that was a patrol or not. What am I worried about? Chinook salmon.
They got us split in half. This is
your chance.
You're free. I was gonna die. Thanks.
Like my grandma always said, get him in the head and they'd be dead.
Wait. Alright. Shinnok Sen. That's what's on there.
Never wore a seatbelt before.
Don't tell me there's something like that. No. Why will not? One spot should be this one. Oh, it's a proper stand here. Awesome. Fresh.
They think carrying a gun makes you strong.
I'm getting my shuffle on over here.
I can have a fish in peace, do I? Alright, anyways. Santa. Ooh, got one. Got one.
Only way we're gonna get rid of all this violence is more violence.
I got one.
What we gotta do.
Oh yeah. I'm on my way. But where would that be?
That's Lansdowne Airstrip. Father here once told my girlfriend, but I got him back. Burned his home down to the ground. Shit, please tell me you didn't hear that last part there.
Oh, this is an airstrip. I could take a plane there.
People and animals and cages. Is that thing normal to you? That's all, Jacob. This is like...
Not sure whether I should fly there or just drive. Oh, we're going there and stop.
Mess the fuck up.
Thanks for the update.
Alright, we're going in style. Woo. Loving the interior.
Peggy's in the house.
Across the river. I knew we should have just taken a helicopter. Oh, there's no way through this. Not like this. Wait a minute. I got you. God.
You don't have to be gentle. You have no respect for the dead.
Freaking Colts.
That could have gone shit real quick.
Let's go get cheaper.
In case you're wondering, I'd love to kill them Peggy's over yonder.
Of course you do. Like, you never mentioned that before. If I were a bear, where would I be? They're gonna have to catch a cheeseburger. Okay, fine cheeseburger. Number one priority. So far. Thank you. Cheeseburger.
I feel higher than a giraffe in Jamaica.
What is wrong with you? Don't tell me that was me.
That is gross. Dead bodies get diseases so fast.
Sometimes I wonder how much more of this fighting I can stop.
Oh, look, I'm famous around.
Oh, this place has some bad memories for me.
Yeah, chick went dumb in here, broke my heart.
Cheeseburger.
Whatever you do, don't be shy or anything. Just get right up in there and give him the salmon. Cuddly little guy will eat it right out of your hand, don't you worry.
Somehow this doesn't seem sanitary. Or safe. Alright, fine, I'll give him the damn salmon. There you go. Cheeseburger. Relax. Relax. Ah, oh, who's a good boy cheeseburger? Good boy cheeseburger. I finally got cheeseburger. What the?
Jacob demands that bear for the reaping!
Wait, cheeseburger! Oh shit. Oh damn it, I didn't see that coming. Love cheeseburger. Damn. Oh crap.
Watch me, I'm moving.
Dude, you can freaking kick ass. You're hired.
Deputy.
Kind of.
I heard you saved old Cheeseburger from the cult. Good work. Fowler boy has trained him well. I'd barrel him all anything you tell him to. And he's something of a local celebrity. So don't be surprised if people care more about him than you.
Oh, gee, Pat.
That time I kissed a skunk on accident.
Cheeseburger.
Always thought Joseph had these assholes on a tight leash. Fake.
Swimming.
Go for a stroll. Cover me.
Come on, cheeseburger. Wait. That just leaves one more, and that's her.
Okay, he's out.
What? Oh, crap. Oh, crap. Time to save drum. Perk. Still save him.
shit, ain't you? I said, get over here. Hey, you're that sumbitch Dutch was going on about. Hey, you. You're that crazy fool what been putting toe to Peggy ass, eh? You a registered voter? Nah, don't matter. I need help of a different sort. Let's get to the point. You see that steaming pile of disappointment over there praying? That's my loin fruit, Hurt Jr. Dumber than a coal bucket. He takes after his mama. Stupid sumbitch went and lost my campaign truck, Nancy. So named after the greatest first lady to ever serve this fine country, of course. If them Obama-loving libtards find out I can't look after my own property, I can kiss this Senate run goodbye. Now, seeing as you're on my land, and I didn't kill you, even though it's well within my rights as a red-blooded American gun owner, I say you owe me. Help numbnuts get my truck back, so I can start focusing on my campaign again. Junior, someone's here to help you. Try not to fuck it up.
Man, I hope they get here soon, because I can't feel my knees anymore. Please, Monkey King, whose art hangs in heaven. I can't do this by myself. So if I'm leader of my own cult, do I start, like, praying to myself then? Is that like prayer inception? Man, I need to get that movie. How am I supposed to get this? Hello, sweet little Monkey King, you up there? It's me, Herc.
Hey, man, I'm sorry. I don't want to go on assuming nobody's gender or nothing. I mean, I don't mean no disrespect. I just call all my homies dude or bro or man, you know, regardless of vagitalia or penile-ness.
Whoa, deja voodoo, man. Have we met before? Dang, man, my prayers have been answered. I got a direct line to that sweet little monkey god whose heart hangs in heaven. Well, I guess since you're an angel working here on Earth, the Monkey King, that you already know I got to get my daddy's truck back. I mean, he's real butt sore. But if we get it back, he'll let me sleep in my bed again. And I gotta tell you, man, it's getting real cold outside. Never mind them wood ticks crawling all up in my junk, threatening me with Lyme disease and whatnot. So come on, man. Help me get my daddy's truck back. Let's make dust before the old man starts shooting. He's hotter than a ghost pepper these days. Senate run's been real stressful on him, man. He ain't cut out for that shit. You know how busy he is? Doesn't even have time to cut out for a shit. Come on, man, get in. Warning light shines in when the light shit, man, I've been praying on this all day, man. I've been asking the Monkey King, all the baby Jesuses, even the Bill of Valentine's one, just to send me a sign, man, and they sent me you. I'll tell you something, though, man. Getting that truck, it ain't gonna be easy. Damn cult's got it, man. I'll be honest with you, it all started when I tried to join them. I mean, it just seemed like a good idea. I mean, they had all these guns, food, fine-ass females, and I mean, those are three things I'm really all about. I mean, it seemed like one big party over there. So I says, hey, Migos, where do I sign up? They said, sign up right here, friend. Then they start listing off all their dang rules, man. No fornicating. Turns out that means fucking. No alcohol and no wilding out and partying, man. No thank you. So I got the fuck out of there, man. Unfortunately, though, I forgot my daddy's truck. He's been real butt sore since, so I gotta get that truck. You don't gotta worry about a thing, man. I got a 9-step plan to get in this truck, man. Step one, catch a day buzz off party liquor. Got that one covered, homie. Step two, pray for someone else to solve my problem. Done. Step three is... shit.
shit. I forget the rest, but they'll come to me as soon as we go. Dang, you are a good listener, Boba Fett. Oh, man doesn't listen at all. I guess that's why I never feel heard. Me and him, we ain't getting along that well lately. Ever since he started running for office, he's been coming down on me real hard about everything. About my public intoxication, how I handle my firearms, stuff like that. But when we get his truck back from them Peggy's, he's gonna be real impressed, dude. He's gonna love me so much, and then my mom's gonna have to try to love me more so she can compete with how much he loves me, and then he'll see how much she's loving me, and then he'll try and love me even more, and then birthdays and Christmases, they're gonna be off the chain. All right, man, this is the place. Mighty Monkey King, whose art in heaven, you have blessed me with the sticky green, the cheap beer, and the sweetest of bros. I party in your name and in your name only. If I could ask you but for one small favor, please, Monkey God, please come down from your heavenly vine and do something about these Peggies. They worship a lesser god than thee, and are killing the beautiful, bountiful buzzes of which you have provided me with today. Amen.
You must have one rough childhood.
I'll be honest with you, man. I took my parents' divorce real personal. I know they say it ain't never the kid's fault, but, man, I took it to heart anyway. Ran away from home. Dude, I was terrified. I had just turned 30 years old, and I didn't know what I was doing, man. I mean, there was a thrill that came with being a runaway and a freedom that I cannot explain. I mean, That's where I found myself, and that is why I recommend running away to every child I meet.
Everything in here is just totaled.
Dude, you should hang out with my little cousin Sharky while you're in town. You met him yet, man? He is fucking good people. Yeah, his parents weren't around so much, so I basically raised him, man. It's kind of like my son in a way. I did a kick-ass job, too, man. He rocks it hard. Real into shooting guns, explosions, and slamming beers, and clams. Oh, man, second coolest dude in Hope County, probably. You'd like it.
Okay, man, now it's time for step four.
Okay, now I see where we get the stupidity from.
Yonder, probably more Peggy's waiting for us, too. It's all about the zipline, man. We're going to zipline in there, sneak up on them like ninjas.
You're kidding. What the heck is Herb doing?
Man, I love the theater.
It's all about the zipline, man. We're going to zipline in there, sneak up on them like ninjas.
Fuck yeah, man!
freaking hurts. Oh shit. Oh man, that scared me.
Feel that breeze on my tank!
Gerani, bro!
Dude, you should hang out with my little cousin Sharky while you're in town. You met him yet, man? He is fucking good people. Yeah, his parents weren't around so much, so I basically raised him, man. It's kind of like my son in a way. I did a kick-ass job, too, man. He rocks it hard. Real into shooting guns, explosions, and slamming beers, and clams. Oh, man, second coolest dude in Hope County, probably. You'd like him. My daddy says there's no way Whitetail's gonna push Jacob out without some help.
That's the truck.
Okay, step five, let's move before more show up. Fuck, man, Daddy is gonna be pissed about these bullet holes, man. Oh, man, we got trouble. Reach into that there cooler. See if we have any cans of whoop-ass left. And pass me a beer if there's one.
This whole
sucker
is too much for me to handle on my own. I'm in need of a campaign manager, and you're just the kind of go-getter I need to get my ass in office. First task I got is to take Junior with you wherever you go.
so I don't have to hear him praying to that goddamn Monkey King no more. Second task is, let me think on it a bit. I'll get back to you.
Not again. Not again. Got out of the bar.
One of you will be strong, not again.
I know you are in pain. The Lord giveth and the Lord taketh. You're not the only one to be tested. Did you know that I had a wife? So beautiful, isn't she? We were pregnant with our first child. And we were just babies ourselves, really. And I was terrified. I'm becoming a father. Mostly about money. She wasn't worried. She had faith that things were gonna work out. She always had faith. And one day she was gonna go visit a friend. There was an accident. The Lord take it. They rushed me to a hospital and put me in a room with this little pink bundle stuffed with tubes. And they said that I had to be strong because my little girl was gonna live. God was looking out for our daughter. And they left me alone in the room with her. I just stared at my daughter. So helpless, so innocent. When all she had in the world was me. When nobody from nowhere was. Fuck. And in that moment, I knew that God was testing me. He was laying out a path before me, and all I had to do was choose. So I put my hand on my little girl's head. And I leaned in and I could smell. And we prayed together. Prayed for wisdom. Prayed for strength. I know. I heard. God's plan for me. I took my fingers and I put them on that little plastic tube that was taped to her angelic face and I pinched it shut. Began to kick in and kick. And then nothing. Stillness. Release. The Lord giveth and the Lord. Take. Pain. Sacrifice. These are all part of his test. When we have to prove that we can serve God. What he asks.
I don't think getting shot in the leg with an arrow is a test of God.
You've done well.
You sick. Not the music box. Watch. That was some sadistic stuff, that man.
Thank you.
my utilities. Can't really tell which way I'm going. Well, that wasn't trippy. That was just trippy. Well, I'm gonna end today's episode here. I gotta go to bed. Oh, shoot. Well, all that's it for today. Leave a like if you like. Later. And if you want to see more content, subscribe to my channel. As always, with the man with no introduction here, peace out.